Hello everyone, welcome to this video on circuits and networks. In this video, we will see how to express Y parameters in terms of Z parameters. From Z parameters, we know that matrix V is equal to matrix Z into matrix I, and matrix I is equal to, can be written as Z inverse into matrix V. And from Y parameters, we know that matrix I is equal to matrix Y into matrix V. So comparing these two equations, we can see that Y is equal to Z inverse. So taking the inverse of the Z parameter gives the corresponding elements of Y, gives the relation between Z and Y parameters. That is one way of doing this. Or what we can do is we can write the equations. That is, we know the Y parameter equations. I1 is equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2. And I2 is equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2. Now we are going to write the Z parameter equations. That is, V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, and V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. Now we can write this in matrix form. So it is like this. So this is of the form AX is equal to B. And here X is the matrix I1, I2. That is the unknown matrix. So we have to find these unknown elements I1 and I2. So in order to find I1, by Cramer's rule, I1 is equal to delta 1 by delta. Delta 1 is obtained by replacing the A matrix, that is the Z parameter matrix, replacing the first column of the A matrix, that is the first column of the Z parameter matrix, which is Z11 and Z21, by the B matrix, which is the voltage matrix, that is V1 and V2. So taking the determinant of that gives delta 1. So in order to find delta 1, we have replaced the first column, that is of this matrix, that is V1 and V2. And the second column is the same, that is Z12 and Z22, divided by delta is the determinant of the Z parameter matrix or the A matrix. So the determinant of that. So we'll get I1. So we can write the numerator as V1 Z22 minus V2 Z12 divided by the determinant of the denominator as Z11 Z22 minus Z21 Z12. So this can be written as I1 is equal to, this thing can be written as delta Z, that is the determinant of Z parameter matrix. So this can be replaced as delta Z, that is the determinant of Z parameter matrix. So we can write I1 is equal to Z22 by delta Z into V1 minus Z12 by delta Z into V2. And we can compare this with the equation of Y parameter, that is I1 is equal to Y11 V1 plus Y12 V2. So both are of the same form. So comparing these two equations, we will get the Y parameters in terms of two parameters, that is Y11 and Y12 in terms of the Z parameters. So Y11 is equal to Z22 by delta Z, and Y12 is equal to minus Z12 by delta Z. Now next we have to find I2. So I2 is by Cramer's rule delta 2 by delta, and delta 2 is obtained by replacing the second column of A matrix, that is the Z parameter matrix, with the B matrix, that is the voltage matrix. So we are replacing the second column. Actually, the second column of the Z parameter matrix is the coefficients of I2 itself. So we are replacing the coefficients of I2 with V1 and V2, and we are finding the determinant of that. That divided by delta, that is the determinant of Z parameter matrix. So we will get it as Z11 V2 minus Z21 V1 divided by determinant of this can be written as delta Z. So we have written like that. So I2 is equal to, we can write the coefficient of V1 as minus Z21 by delta Z into V1, and the coefficient of V2 is Z11 by delta Z into V2. So comparing this with the Y parameter equation, that is I2 is equal to Y21 V1 plus Y22 V2, we can write Y21 is equal to minus Z21 by delta Z, and Y22 is equal to Z11 by delta Z. So we have found all the Y parameters in terms of the Z parameters. So this can be written in matrix form like this. That is, the equivalent Z parameters are shown here. That is, a simple way of remembering this is, that is, the Y parameter matrix is Y11, Y12, Y22, Y21 and Y22. So the corresponding equivalent Z parameter matrix is obtained as, we have to replace this diagonal elements Y11, Y22 with the opposites. That is, instead of Y11, we are writing here Z22, and instead of Y22, we are replacing it with Z11. And here, these two elements are the same. That is, Y12, here it is Z12 itself, and Y21, here it is Z21 itself. But we are giving a negative to that. So it is minus Z12 and minus Z21 divided by delta Z. So Y11 is equal to Z22 by delta Z. Y12 is equal to minus Z12 by delta Z. y21 is equal to minus z21 by delta z, and y22 is equal to z11 by delta z. So we have expressed all the y parameters in terms of the z parameters. Now we'll see a problem on finding the z parameters of a network given the z parameters. So the z parameters are given as z11 is equal to 1, z12 is equal to 0.5, z21 is equal to 0.5, and z22 is equal to 1. So we have to find the y parameters. So we know that y11 is equal to z22 divided by delta z, and y12 is equal to minus z12 by delta z. y21 is equal to minus z21 by delta z, and y22 is equal to z11 by delta z. So we can find each of this element. So that is y11 is equal to z22 by delta z. So z22 is 1, delta z is, so first let's find delta z. So delta z is z11 z22 minus z12 into z21. So z11 here is 1, and z22 is also 1. So 1 into 1 minus z12 is 0.5, and z21 is also 0.5. So that is 1 minus 0.25. That is 0.75. So delta z is 0.75. Now let's find y11. y11 is z22 divided by delta z. So z22 here is 1. So 1 by 0.75. Next is, let us find y12. y12 is minus z12 by delta z. And minus z12 is 0.5. Minus 0.5. So minus 0.5 by 0.75. Next is y21. y21 is minus z21 by delta z, and that is equal to minus 0.5. z21 is 0.5 divided by delta z is 0.75. So that is y21. Next is y22. So y22 was z11 by delta z, and here z11 is 1. So 1 divided by 0.75. So we have obtained all the y parameters given the z parameters. And initially we have seen that matrix y is equal to matrix z inverse. So by taking the inverse of the z parameter matrix, we can find y parameter matrix also. So that is, we have to find the inverse of this matrix, z parameter matrix. So z parameter matrix is, I'll show you how to take the inverse. So that is z11, z12, z21, and z22. We have to take the inverse of this particular matrix. So inverse is obtained by taking adjoint divided by determinant. And adjoint of the matrix is the cofact of the transpose matrix, that divided by the determinant of this matrix gives the inverse matrix. So let us take the cofactor matrix. So in order to write the cofactor matrix, what we have to do is, the first element of the cofactor matrix is obtained by eliminating the first column and first row. So the element is z22. So minus 1 raised to, we are writing the 1 element. So minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 into the element obtained by eliminating the first row and the first column. That is z22. And the second element is obtained by, eliminating the first row and the second column. This element is in the 1-2 position. So we have to eliminate the first row and the second column. So the remaining element is z21, and it is minus 1 raised to, it is the 1-2 element. So minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 into z21. And here, in order to get this corresponding element here, over here, what we have to do is, we have to z21 element, corresponding element of z21 element. What we have to do is, we have to eliminate the second row and the first column. So it is minus 1 raised to, it is a 2-1 element. So minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1 into the element obtained by eliminating the second row and the first column, that is z12. And here the element is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2 into the element obtained by eliminating the second row and the second column. So the remaining element is z11. This is the cofactor matrix. We have to take the transpose of the cofactor matrix divided by determinant of this matrix. Determinant of this matrix is Z11, Z12, Z11, Z22, minus Z12, Z21. So let's take the transpose of this matrix. So this is minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1. So I'm going to write that once again. So it is plus 1. Minus 1 raised to 1 plus 1 is plus 1. So this is Z22. Here minus 1 raised to 1 plus 2 is minus 1. So minus Z21. Here minus 1 raised to 2 plus 1 is minus 1. So minus Z12. And here it is minus 1 raised to 2 plus 2. So it is again plus 1. That into Z1. We have to take the transpose of this matrix. This is the cofactor matrix. We have to take the transpose of that divided by determinant of Z parameter matrix. So Z11, Z22 minus Z12, Z21. So that is, we can write this as Z22, taking the transpose, Z22 minus Z12 minus Z21, Z11 divided by delta Z. So this is the Y parameter matrix. This is the relation between Y parameter and Z parameter. So the Y parameter elements are Y11, Y12, Y21, Y22. So you can compare and you will get each of these elements. We have seen this already. So that's all. Thank you.